Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm happy you are here, so which means you did like the previous episode. So yeah, in this week unfortunately Bob is busy, so we cannot go further with the GSX600K6 build video, but luckily I have three other project bikes, so I'm gonna work on one of those today. I just got to the garage, I'm gonna show you in a minute. So this is my garage. It's not too big, it's mostly for storing. I have a trailer to pick up bikes and the wing bikes taken back. So at this moment I have these three project bikes. I'm gonna work on this one today because something is not going well with the carburetors. The bike just doesn't want to fire up when it's cold. If you spray some liquid, then sometimes it's gonna run. So that's what we're gonna find out today. And this is one more GSX600F from 95, I believe. And this is this was my bike. Unfortunately, I had an accident with it, and the frame is gone, so the bike is not usable anymore, but I have all the parts, to be honest, for one more bike. I'm missing a frame and some additionals. What I'm gonna get, you're gonna get more information about it later. So let's get to the chase. So I take out the tools from the car, and I did start to take off the bike. I did disconnect the fuel lines already. And the other side of the tank, it has some bleeding hoses for overrunning for the fuel if you tank or rain coming down. There's a hole which is running out of the side of the bike, and the fuel gauge is disconnected, and the vacuum which is operating the petcock. So then for sure the bike gonna get some fuel. So I got this far already, the tank is off, the tank supported, the air filter, I took it off already, so I'm about to take off the carburetor. I have another one which I have been cleaned yesterday, so that for sure no any dirt in it, and nice and clean, working everything properly. So let's swap it and let's find out when to start or not. So the new carburetor is on. I didn't put back the airbox yet, just to make a test run, how it's gonna start, how it's gonna acting, so it can get more airflow, and if I have to adjust something, then it's much easier. So as you see, the fuel cock is on running. So let's give it a try. It definitely doesn't sound too good. The battery ran flat, so I'm just gonna hook up with another battery. So I hooked up the other battery, so let's check. Maybe we have more luck this time. Something is not really going well. That's not a good news, guys. Maybe we should wait a little bit more, or should try to spray it. So I have some brake cleaner over here, so let's try. Give one more try. It's not to work, so it should. And even the other battery running flat, so let's fire up the other bike, get some charge. Another bike, we're gonna have some charge to the battery, so maybe it's gonna be enough now.
We'll be right back.
unfortunately the carburetors are soaking wet and they don't want to really fire up. So I have to take a little bit more investigation what's going on. I have to pull the spark plugs probably and check them. And maybe they just got too much fuel at this moment and choked the system. So let's find out. So I took out the spark plugs. As you can see, all of them are really wet. But to be honest, yesterday I've been here and did try to fire up the bike. That's why I know it doesn't start at when it's really cold. And I did try to spray it, but it seems definitely to overflow the plugs. So I'm just gonna clean them and put back in the bike and let's see what's gonna be. Maybe it's gonna help. So another bike is on to try to charge a little bit the battery. I put back the spark plugs and let's see what's gonna happen now. So luckily it did start up. I'm gonna put back the tank because it's gonna run flat by the fuel. So yes, it's a success. So let's get back together. So luckily now the bike is running. I did put back the carburetors and now it's just roughly attached. The bike is running. We're gonna need some final touch, so but at this moment it's enough. So yeah, it's success, the bike did run up. Now it's gonna work, luckily. So now I'm gonna just put back everything together and then next time I'm gonna put the bike on the synchronization device and gonna check again the spark plugs because I just did adjust by, sorry. I just did put the carburetor on the one setup. So we'll see if it's good or not. Does the bike get enough fuel or maybe too much? That's why that was maybe the problem with the previous carburetor. Maybe just got too much benzene, too much gas. Sorry. So yeah, this is the next step. So let's see. So I take out one spark plug, and as you guys can see, it's so dark and it has a lot of carbon deposit on it. And I just did clean a few minutes ago. So that means the bike running rich, really, really rich, super rich. Get a lot of fuel, so that means we have to adjust back a little bit. That's the next step. So the carburetors has a pilot screw, or called idle fuel gas fuel and air mixture screw, which are most of the bottom. If it's closer to the engine side, then it's adjusting the fuel amount. If it's away for the nozzle side, it's adjusting the air amount. So these are quite out, so I'm gonna readjust them and take away some fuel from the bike. After the adjustment, I did let the bike run for a while and I pulled again the spark plug. It still get a lot of fuel, so I still have to take away yet. I did finish the bike back together. I just gotta put back the seat. Now it's running nicely, a little bit over RPM. I finished it, now it's running. I'm really happy with the result. Only one thing, I don't have my synchronization device with me, so I cannot adjust the carburetors for each other. Because you can adjust the fuel ratio, how much fuel goes into the bike. And when you have multiple cylinder bikes, like 2, 3, 4, then all the cylinders are wearing down differently by time. So sometimes you have to adjust the carburetors for each other, which means there's a device, you have to put it on the bike. The bike has to run. And then you see which cylinder, how much air goes into the cylinder. And with this device you can see, and there are adjusters in the carburetor, between every carburetor. But yeah, I cannot do it today. So this is for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and see you in the next one. Have a nice day. Bye bye.